I mean, we all know there's no such thing as perfect, right? But at least in Photoshop, we can get it a little closer to perfect. With Shake and Bacon, I'm Joni Simon. Welcome to my studio. This is where I do food photography, and the goal here is to improve your food photography skills so you feel confident behind the camera. Today, we're diving into Photoshop to show you three different ways that you can use the spot healing brush tool, which is something that's a great thing for cleaning up little issues in an image, just those little imperfections to take it to the next level. But maybe there's some modes in there that you haven't used before, so we're gonna go ahead and dive on in. So today, we're gonna be working on these cupcakes, which were actually leftovers from the sparkler video that I made a couple weeks ago. In case you missed that, I've got it linked down below. But these were just leftover extras that I had sitting around. And as I was cleaning up, I mean, you know this happens, right? As you're cleaning up, all of a sudden you look at it and you're like, oh, that's a great shot right there, right? I just had a bunch of these on a tray, on that baking tray that's really nice and busted up. You know, good busted up baking tray is a food photographer's favorite thing. But you can see I've got all sorts of like the glitter, the edible glitter, and the luster dust, and it's just created this really cool texture there. And so I really love this photo, but there's some little cleanups we can do to it. So we're gonna go ahead and dive on into this. If you wanted to go behind the scenes of this photo, just head on over to my Instagram link down below, and you can go ahead and see how I set up the lighting, how this was all shot. So in case that's helpful, you can head over there. So you can see I've got this image here in Capture One, and I have been using Capture One pretty exclusively at this point for the last several months. There are definitely a lot of really cool advanced features in terms of the tethering abilities in Capture One that really are unmatched in any other software. And I've started to really get used to editing my images in here. But if you are editing your images in Camera Raw or Lightroom, whatever you're using for sort of that baseline editing to get your image to kind of where you want it in terms of contrast and color and all those things, because all we're going to do here in Photoshop today is just some little cleanup of some of the imperfections. You know, if we kind of zoom in here, you can see these little blips, and we've got these little like crumbs and these little spots where it's not quite perfect. We're gonna go ahead and clean that up in Photoshop. But just for curiosity's sake, we got a little before and a little after, so you can see just some of those adjustments that I made in terms of editing. So let's go ahead and take this over into Photoshop. This is a kind of a similar method that you could do in any one of your editing softwares, is you can take it from that over into Photoshop. So I'm just gonna right click and I'm gonna hit edit with and Adobe Photoshop 2021. And that's gonna go ahead and prompt this to edit the variant, and we're gonna head on over into Photoshop. Now, I know there's plenty of y'all out there who are looking at this and thinking, oh my gosh, I've never even stepped foot in Photoshop. This feels very overwhelming, and I completely understand that feeling. One of my big goals in 2020 was really to up my Photoshop skills, and I'm super glad that I did. There are tons of great educational resources out there, free ones like Flurn here on YouTube and PixImperfect. Can't recommend them enough. There's also Udemy, and there's lynda.com. If you're looking for something very specific to food photography, my friend Rachel at Two Love Studio, she has got a retouching food photography course, which I've been through. It's excellent. So if you're looking at this tutorial and you're thinking, I don't even know where to start with this, you're speaking another language, Joni, I totally understand. Tons of resources out there. I'll link some helpful ones below. All right, so we are gonna start off by creating a new layer. We hit the plus sign, and that is going to create this new layer. If you're not familiar with this layers concept, effectively the idea is that, for example, when we're in Lightroom, we can make all sorts of edits and changes, and then, you know, maybe go, oh, I don't really like that edit that I did a couple steps back. I wanna undo that. Super easy to do that in Lightroom, right? Whereas here in Photoshop, if we're working directly on that background layer, making edits and changes, and two is, you know, we do a lot of little cleanups over the course of an image. If we all of a sudden want to go back and undo something we did like 20 steps ago, you can't just undo it. You've got to kind of either peel back those layers or start anew, which isn't going to work. So when we're in Photoshop, we work in layers so that we are maintaining that background as it was originally intended, and that we're only making changes to individual layers so we can isolate changes as they happen. And then if we want to undo something, we can just go back into that specific layer and fix that there. This is how we help to ensure a non-destructive process in our editing. So just to make it easy, I'm gonna go ahead and change the name of this, double click. This is going to be our cleanup layer. And honestly, that's all I'm gonna be doing here in this image in Photoshop today is cleaning it up. I already like the contrast, all those edits I made in Lightroom. Those are all great and good. I'm not gonna make any other like changes in that regard to this image. It's only gonna be just this little cleanup. So what are we gonna clean up? Well, let's go ahead and look at, we've got all these little, I don't know, blips and burps, and I think there's just little air pockets that come out as you're piping that frosting. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna work with the Spot Healing Brush Tool here today, which is on the left-hand side, and you can see I've selected Spot Healing Brush Tool. Now, of course, there are tons of other tools here in Photoshop, and there's lots of different ways to do lots of different things in Photoshop. So certainly if you have a method that you prefer, that's great. But then theoretically too, if you already have a preferred method for cleaning things up, maybe you're not watching this video. I digress. Anyway, Spot Healing Brush Tool is what we're working with here today for this situation. And what you can see across the top here are the specifications for how we're gonna use this tool, for how this tool is gonna work in this situation. So what we're gonna do is make sure that we're sampling all layers, right? So that we're making the changes here on the cleanup layer, it's highlighted, but that we're pulling from that background layer underneath. And then we're doing the content aware. So effectively, anytime we're using this Spot Healing Brush Tool, it's sort of surveying the surrounding area and saying, okay, this little spot where it's not like everything else, right? One of these things is not like the other, that we're gonna change that so that it blends in with the surrounding area. And then we've got the mode, which we're gonna keep in normal for now. We're gonna play with that here just a moment. And then you can change the size of your brush, the softness or hardness of the brush, or what I like to do is a nice little shortcut here. You hold down the Alt key and the right mouse button. You hold those both down. If I scroll to the right, it'll make it larger, to the left, smaller. And then if I move it up, it makes it a softer brush, right? So more of a gradual edge to it, as opposed to a harder brush, which has a harder lined edge. So in this case, I'll keep it just a little soft. There we go. Okay, so I've got the Spot Healing Brush Tool, all those settings. So now what I can do is I can just come over any one of these little issue areas and just boop, 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 clean it up. Awesome, right? Before and after, right? We can just turn off that layer, turn it back on, looks great. So we can continue to do that throughout these different areas and really clean up. Now, certainly this is all sort of a matter of like personal taste and how far you want to take it in perfecting an image. We know there's no such thing as a perfect image, but just depends on the application too. I mean, we're pretty zoomed in. So I mean, if we're posting this on Instagram, is anybody really gonna see all those little things? Maybe, maybe not. Well, we'll wait until we get to the end, right? But we can just continue to do our little Spot Healing Brush Tool, clean up these little imperfections, and we are rocking and rolling. Now, inevitably, as you're using this tool, something that will happen is you will apply that Spot Healing Brush Tool in an area and you'll look at it and you'll go, that doesn't look right. That looks too smooth, kind of looks a little fuzzy. It looks obvious that you have applied a Photoshop edit there. I don't know if that's happened to you. It certainly happened to me. And that's why then we can come in and we can manipulate the mode. So right now we're in the normal mode, but what we can do is we can use my other two favorite modes, which are the darken mode or the lighten mode. And I think the easiest way to understand these is to use them. So what we're gonna think about in terms of darken or lighten. So if we say, for example, we wanna clean up these little light crumbs that are right here, or sugar crystals or whatever the heck they are, if we wanna get rid of those. So in this situation, those little crumbs are lighter than the surrounding area, right? So what we wanna do is we want to darken those. Well, if we go ahead and select the darken tool, what that's gonna do is if I apply that little Spot Healing Brush Tool right there in the darken mode, it is gonna leave anything in the surrounding area that's darker, it's going to leave it alone. So anything that is like the area or darker, it's not gonna touch it. But if it's lighter, it's going to change that. It is going to heal that spot. So in this case, that little piece of sugar, right? It's lighter than the surrounding area, so I'm going to darken it and it goes away. But at the same time, it has not affected the texture of the surrounding area. It is only getting rid of those lighter areas while leaving the darker areas alone. Really cool, right? This is how, when in situations where we go in and we make an edit with the spot healing brush tool and it makes things too soft and it affects our texture, which, I mean, that's like a cardinal sin of food photography, right? We wanna really retain the texture in our food. The texture is what really gives us those visual cues of how we're gonna experience that food. So we don't wanna mess with our texture. So in situations where it's just overly softening things, select either the lighten or the darken, depending on what you wanna fix, and only isolate, only fix specifically those pixels so that you can see, again, when I do this in darken mode, everything that's already the color of the area, it's leaving it alone. It's not touching it. It's saying, oh, I can't make that darker. It's already the color of the area. It is only going to darken the lighter stuff. So this is a way that we can have, you can see, right? For example, this kind of little line going on here, I'm doing darken. Well, it's not gonna do anything because it's already dark, right? But the light stuff goes away. Super cool. Now here's another great example, right? If we come over to this spot, what do we wanna do with that spot? Do we wanna darken it? Or do we want to lighten it? That's right, we want to lighten it. And so if we come up here, let's just say, for example, on accident we select darken, right? Because we do want to lighten that spot. But let's just say we selected the darken on accident and we come over here, nothing happens, right? Because there's nothing to darken, it's already dark. Whereas if I select lighten, let's come on up here, select lighten, come over it, goes away. That is super duper helpful, yet still maintaining the surrounding texture, that it's not affecting what is already lighter, what is already the color of that surrounding area. It's leaving it alone. It is only the darker areas that it's lightening, and vice versa. If it's a lighter spot that we want to clean up on a dark area, then we want to darken it, right? So we can go through and continue to do that. It's just really helpful for isolating in situations where you either want to lighten or darken, but really retain the texture that you've got going on. All right, and oh, here's another area. Let's see if you can guess it this time. We've got this dark spot right here. What do we wanna do with the dark spot? We wanna darken it or lighten it? We wanna lighten it, right? So make sure we're in the lighten mode. And then I'm just gonna make it a little bit bigger. Nice, got rid of it. Kaboom. All these little dark spots here, it's just blending them right in while leaving the texture of that area where it's lighter, leaving it unaffected. This is just such a great way to really isolate these edits and these changes so that they are much less noticeable, so that you're not seeing like, oh, we've really messed up the texture of that area. So there's a lot in the spot healing brush tool. It's definitely a lot of fun to play with. Again, to really cement this learning, I highly recommend hopping over into Photoshop right now and starting to practice this. But you'll find, especially in certain situations, it will become so clear that that lighten and the darken modes are especially helpful for different edits. So now at this point, we have flown through, done all those little edits. We've got our perfected cupcake. So now if I do that before and the after, you can just really see how much that's really cleaned things up. Again, before, after, even looking there at the cookie tray, before and after. I love a good before and after, you too. But now at this point, what we can do is go ahead and save this image. Just hit that Control S or Command S. And what that will do is it will save that file and pop it back over into either Lightroom or in this case, Capture One. And from there, you can go ahead and proceed with your typical exporting process, depending on where that image is going, exporting it to the size that you need and the specifications that you need, and share your fabulous image with the world. So hopefully this has got you excited to dive into Photoshop, try these tools out if you hadn't already. And certainly, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I'll be back next week with another video. And so with that, you stay out of trouble and I'll see you soon, okay? Bye.